My name is Laura, and I'm Kazmira's one and only best friend. Kessie and I go back to Hazel on the Hill in West Orange since kindergarten. And even to this day, I couldn't imagine a day without her by my side. And I hope that LaDerek feels the same.
Absolutely.
All right. I've literally... Can y'all still hear me? We good? Okay. All right. I've literally watched her grow and transform over the years, and even though there were times where we didn't speak as frequently as other seasons, I know that she was someone I could always call on to laugh, ugly cry, and exchange terrible advice with. I'll never forget the day that she called to tell me she was pregnant. Y'all want to know what my first question was?
What was it tell me?
Who did you tell first? She doesn't know this, but I cried so ugly after we got off of that call because I didn't know what that meant for our future as best friends. And with her becoming a mother, if we would have the same common interests, goals, or even conversations beyond that point. In actuality, though, Kessie became my biggest inspiration. I admire the woman she's become, the incredible mother that she is. All right. In actuality, though, Kessie became my biggest inspiration. I admire the woman she's become, the incredible mother that she is, and the level of strength that she has that she sometimes doesn't even realize that she has. Throughout her ups and downs, I have covered her in prayer and just asked God to not only invite a God-fearing man into her life, but one that would love her and appreciate her for just how amazing she is. I wanted someone to see her for more than her physical appearance, because y'all, my best friend is gorgeous, okay? But someone who could see her spiritually, emotionally, and really understand the entirety of this woman that is sitting before all of you today. I want to thank her mommy and daddy for creating such a gentle, loving, empathetic, brave, incredible human being. And I want to thank Lederic for recognizing that and giving my best friend, my soul sister, all the greatness in the world that she deserves. I've said this once and will continue to say these words with every opportunity I get, but Lederic, thank you for loving my best friend. Okay. All right, y'all, I'm almost done for real. All right. She may enjoy date nights, long walks on the beach, surprise gifts when she comes home, and so many other cliche things, but you know by now that she is worth it based on all of the sacrifices you both make for each other. I have just one verse to share, and I'll let Danny get to talking, but I just want to share 1 Corinthians 13, verse 7. It's the New International Version for those of you that need to know. But love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. Okay. Amen. All right. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. I love you both, and I would have flown across the country for this special moment. I wish you the best in this union to have and to hold from this day forward till death do you part. Thank you, everyone, for being here for this beautiful moment.
Yeah.
Cue that music for me.
What's up, everybody? What's up? All right, I just want to make sure, before I say anything, I want to make sure I got some support and some energy from the union group. Y'all right here? Y'all hear that noise? My dog, Lederic, has his tribe in here. He has his tribe, his brotherhood in here, and I just wanted to make sure that he heard that. You know, you get that energy, all right? All right, so I'm gonna start this off. I don't want this to be just about me being his best man or anything like that. All of us have a space in Lederic's life, and we all get a chance to sit at a dinner table. Throughout our time, spending time with Lederic, we all get a chance to sit at a dinner table. And a lot of times, you think it's like a literal dinner table, but our dinner table was music, all right? And so we got a chance to really cultivate character, love, integrity, vision, and discipline. And I want to say shout out to Miss Perry, because a lot of times, Listen. Yes, 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 yes. I want to say shout out to Miss Perry, because there were a lot of times where we got so lost in our vision and our love for music, where she had to remind us discipline was in order. So when we was in the garage practicing music and all of that, she would shut it down when LaDerrick didn't do what he was supposed to do, right? But the beautiful thing about that is we all got a chance to learn discipline together, even through his own life, that we know that love, vision, and discipline is what contributes to this man being such a high value man. It's not really the number that's in his pocket, but the fact that he has visions, because we know without vision, you perish. And that you can take care of your family, and she can be that helpmeet to the vision that you have. All right, so you never leave that. So, no, I'm not here to preach, but I'm here to talk facts. What I'm telling you is what this man lives, all right? So just to rewind just a little bit, we met LaDerrick, I think he was in like sixth grade? It was the eighth grade? All right, LaDerrick was in eighth grade, y'all. All right, pay attention to this. LaDerrick was in eighth grade. Eric, you remember this. Eric and I, we had a little tour. We went back to South Orange Middle School, and we did like a little show there. And you remember LaDerrick got on stage and was pop blocking. Anybody who knows LaDerrick, he likes to pop block. Hey, DJ, hey, hold on, y'all, right. Hey, DJ, I need you to give me 20 seconds of what I asked you for, all right? Just 20 seconds. Come on, 20 seconds. Come on. 20 seconds. Hello? All right. I just needed 20 seconds of that. You don't remember that? Yo. So, all right. I swear, I'm not going to be too long. All right. So, after meeting LaDerrick, he was filled with so much vision and so much love and passion for it. His teachers gave me so much advice about him. You know, they told me that this young kid has so much vision, life, and that moment we met him, he was so inspired. And then not realizing that later on in today's life that he would be inspiring us, because he always kept vision, love, and discipline in his life. And his mother really helped with that. And I just want to say thank you for being such a man of integrity, a man that's consistent. And I know that you will take care, great care of this family, because you have love, vision, and discipline. All right? Let's raise our glass to LaDerrick, to this high value man. And we pray that he always keeps these principles, so that way he takes great care of this beautiful woman that would guard his vision, his love, and his passion for what he does. Salute to you, LaDerrick. Salute. Don't worry, I didn't forget his lovely wife. His sister is on the way to take care of all of that. Where you at? Robin? All right, anyway. Salute.
Hello? Aw, that was nice, Danny. That was so beautiful. Is everyone having a good time? How was the food? Are you full? I don't like this. You guys are quiet over here. Hello, hi family. I know that's right. So I am Robin Lynn. I am Kesmere's only sister. And so I wrote a little speech. I definitely had to condense it because it was really long. Okay, so I introduced myself. Sorry, y'all. I was truly honored when my sister asked me to be her maiden of honor. Now, my parents aren't giving a speech today, but I definitely want to acknowledge them. Mommy and Daddy. I know they want to thank you guys for coming. And to the Perry family, welcome to our family. We're a wild bunch. We love God, we love music, and we love you guys. To the bride, my sister, Daddy's kiss kiss, Mommy's poopy, Enrico's baby kissy, Reagan's auntie Casey, Hampton's mommy, and now LaDerek's wife. How does that sound? So my sister and I are actually only 5 years apart. I'm not gonna tell you how old I am, but if you know how old she is, y'all do the math. I remember when my mom was pregnant with my sister and we'd rub her belly, my brother and I, and I used to just hope that it was a girl. I'm like, please, I want a sister. Please, God, give me a sister. And I remember when my dad came home and he told us, Mommy had the baby. And we're like, okay, what's she have? What's she have? And he's like, it was a girl. My cousin Stephanie and I, who is our coordinator and planner extraordinaire, we were excited, we were thrilled. My brother, not so much. That was the first time I heard the words, Enrico, calm down. You came into our lives, changed everything. You even changed some of the rules. If you don't believe me, when you get a chance, ask my sister about the remote. We weren't allowed to touch the remote. You had to walk into the room, claim the remote, so then that way you can watch whatever you wanted. If you exited the room, you had to say, I'm leaving the remote in order to change a channel. My sister is also the only kid I knew that never walked to school. My dad, every morning, drove her to school. My brother and I, we walked. We took the bus. She was definitely spoiled, but one thing you guys don't know is my sister is the youngest grandchild on my paternal side. So she is the baby. We spoil her, we love on her, whatever she needs. If one doesn't have it, she goes to the next, she goes to the next, she goes to the next, and eventually it gets to her. I'm almost done, y'all, I promise. Kesmir, you have been my shadow, my hip, your name is Kesmir Olivia Christine Gilliam Perry. You have been my shadow, my hip, my pain, my mannequin. Thank you for letting me experiment on your hair. My secret keeper, a listening ear, and oftentimes my tissue when I cry. You may be my little sister, but you've proven time and time again how big you really are. I pray that as you embark on this journey, as a wife, you honor God, you remember your purpose, and you count your blessings. Now, to my only brother-in-law. When Kesmir told me that you were interested in her, I encouraged her to speak with you. So some of you may not know this, but I've actually known LaDerek for about 15 years. I've known him a very long time. We knew each other at church and we fellowshiped together. He was also a guest at my wedding. I have always called LaDerek my brother. And he always reminds me, I spoke this into existence. My brother is marrying or has married my, it sounds kind of crazy, but y'all get what I'm saying. LaDerek, I pray that as you embark on this journey as a husband, that you remember your purpose, you count your blessings, and you honor God. Marriage is a good thing. Trust God, build a solid foundation, find a beauty in every season, no matter what it looks like. Be blessed. Congratulations, I love you both.
Hey guys. We want to just say that we appreciate everyone for coming tonight. If you came from far or near, we appreciate all of it. Some people took flights from LA, my bro. Some people took flights from Haiti, from Florida. I don't know, but I'm just saying, you know what I mean? Some people took flights from far places, and we appreciate everyone who came. But the party isn't over. We getting all the formalities out of the way so we can dance, y'all. So after this little speech that I'm giving right now, we gonna hit the floor, all right? For real, I want to see everybody dancing. I don't want to see anybody sitting down. You want to say something?
Sure. I never say anything. But I am very, very grateful for all of you who have come today. I feel so blessed. I know LaDerek and I are so blessed, so thankful. You all are wonderful. All the love we've gotten, you know, all the gifts we've gotten, all the help we've gotten. Everyone in our bridal party, thank you for tolerating me. I really wasn't that difficult, y'all. I have been very chill. You were very chill too. Anyways, thank you guys for coming. I hope you have fun. I love you all.
Thank you. One more thing. We have to shout out our parents, Mama Perry, Papa G, Mama G, and Stephanie. You made all of this happen. We appreciate you so much. We love you. Expect a gift from us, okay? Pastor Sharon, if you're still here, I don't know if you're still here. I appreciate you coming from North Carolina to be with us. All right, let's party, let's go.
Jerusalem, ikayala mi, ilondoloze.